Hello everyone. In this video session, I am going to explain part 163 of Java for testers, that is not initializing the variables using constructors resulting default values. So what does that mean? So in Java, we use constructors to simplify the initialization of variables in a class, right? As explained in one of the previous videos, the purpose of the constructors is to simplify the initialization of the variables in a class, okay? But what if I don't use any constructor in the class, okay? What if I will not use or create any constructor inside the class? Thereby, what will happen to the variables of that class? If I don't use the constructor inside the class for initializing those variables, what will happen to that variables of that class? So guys, if you don't use a constructor for initializing the variables of the class, default values, okay, default values will be assigned to those variables, okay? Default values will be assigned to those variables. For example, if there is a variable of in data type, the value like 0 will be assigned, okay? The default value 0 will be assigned. If there is a variable of boolean data type, then false value will be assigned. If there is a variable of string data type, then null value will be assigned. If there is a variable of cat data type, nothing will be assigned, okay? Like that, guys. If there is a variable of double data type, okay, 0.0 default value will be assigned, okay? If you don't initialize the variables of a class using the constructors, then automatically default values like this will be assigned to those variable types. Let me practically demonstrate this to you guys, okay? So let's create a class, new class. I'll create a class known as car. Any name you can create, guys, okay? Or else I will create something like class A. Finish. And in this class A, I'll create the variables. Let's say byte A is equal to byte A. That's it, okay? I'm not initializing any values here. Byte A, short b, int c, long d, float e, double f, okay, char g, boolean h, like this, different variables I declared. Now I'm not creating any constructor to initialize all these variables of different data types. Directly what I will do is I'll create a method like this, okay? Public void details, okay? Details. I'm just creating a method known as details, okay? Normal method. Inside this details method, I'll try to print the variables, okay? Without initializing these variables, I'm trying to print, okay? The variable, the byte variable A, colon. I'll say plus, like this, okay? Plus this A I will be printing, okay? What is stored inside the byte variable A, okay? Like that. Similarly, I will try to copy paste this statement multiple times so that I can do this for all the variables. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 I will do. And here how many are there? 8 are there. One more thing, 9. Here I will also create a variable with string, okay? String I. So 9. So here A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, one more extra is there. So I will remove this last one. This will be enough. And first one is byte, then short, int, long. Then we have float, double, char. This is char. This is boolean. This is string. Okay. And here I'll make A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, okay? Now, how to call this method? So for that, I'll try to create another class. I'll name this class as demo with public static void main method. I'll move it this side so that you can see both the classes at same time. And in order to call this method details method so that all the statements will be executed and all the default values assigned to this variables will be printed. Okay, since I have not initialized these variables, some default values will be assigned, guys. Okay, some default values will be assigned to this different variables automatically by Java. And when you try to execute this details method, all these variables, default values of these variables without initialization will be printed. Okay, when not initialized will be printed. So how to do that? We have to create an object for this class, right? Class A, class A is equal to A object is equal to new class A, like this. Okay, now I will call this method using this object reference of this class. I will call the method details method of this class A, that is object A dot details. Okay, like this, that's it. So here, guys, before I run anything, I'll explain that there are different types of variables created here without any initialization done, right? Even there is no constructor for simplifying the initialization process. In such kind of case, okay, if you try to access this variables, okay, if you try to access these variables, okay, and try to print the values stored in them without initialization, if you try to print the values stored into that variables, okay, the default values will be printed. Default values of each and every variable type will be printed, guys. So let's see what are the default values that we are going to get for each and every variable type here. So right click, run as Java application. Okay, so you see the byte variable is assigned with some default value 0. Okay, default values will be assigned to all these variables, guys. Okay, short also same, int also same, all these integer variables same thing, guys. 0000, like decimal type, like float and double, 0.0, 0.0. coming to the char, you see nothing is there. Okay, blank space, you can say it as space, guys. Okay, this is a space got assigned to this char, single character space kind of. Boolean variable h, you see out of true false only false is a default value of the boolean. Okay, got assigned. And string, as there is nothing, null. Okay, there is no object created for the string, so null will be printed. Like this, guys, default values will be printed, okay, will be resulted when you don't initialize the variables inside the class using the constructors. Okay, so we have to use constructors to initialize the variables, otherwise the default values will be resulted when trying to print those variables. So this is about this session, guys. In the next video session, I'll explain different types of constructors we have in Java. So that's it, guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.